Hey, what's up guys, it's Renaldo here. So this video is going to focus on the current state of South Africa. This is a video that you can consider a pocket guide that you can share with your friends, family, colleagues, and people that you know overseas. So for ease of reference, I'm going to break this video up into three broad categories: crime, the economy, and corruption. So with that being said, let's get into the first category, namely crime. In the 2018-19 financial year, there were more than 21,000 murders in South Africa, which leads to a murder rate every single day in this country of 59 murders a day. Now, with that shocking murder rate, what usually falls along the wayside is the attempted murder rate. Now, you would be surprised to know that there were 19,000 attempted murders during that same period, which doesn't form part, obviously, of the murder rate. And if you had to break that down into a daily number, that is 52 attempted murders every single day. Now, another shocking statistic is the rape rate in South Africa. There are 113 reported cases of rape every single day in South Africa. Now, it's important to note, those are only the ones that are reported. And we know that close to 50% of rapes don't get reported in this country. Now, when it comes to assaults in South Africa, the number is staggering. We've got 912 assaults every single day in this country. Now, 444 of those are common assaults, which means you are pushed or shoved against your will. And then 468 of those are with the intent to do grievous bodily harm. Now, when it comes to robberies in this country, the numbers don't get any better. There's 587 robberies every single day in South Africa. Now, 142 of those are common robberies, 61 of those robberies are house robberies, and then 384 of those robberies are with aggravating circumstances, which is the serious robberies. So all in all, you can clearly see that there's a massive problem when it comes to crime in South Africa. The problem, however, is that we've got just over 200,000 police officers to police 60 million people in this country. And as long as that's going to take place, then we are not going to get a handle on crime, and we are going to be considered the crime capital of the world in so many various different fields. Now, when it comes to the economy, things don't look much better. Currently, South Africa owes over 3 trillion rand in debt. And when it comes to repaying that 3 trillion rand of debt, that repayment works out to about 15% of our budget revenue in South Africa. So our repayments alone on servicing debt, it makes up 15% of the budget revenue that we earn. Now, to put this into perspective, the total revenue generated by the government each year is 1.58 trillion rand. But yet the amount of money that we are spending is 1.95 trillion. So there's a 370 billion rand deficit, and we can't plug those holes. So this is where the government comes in and tax people more through sin tax, through the fuel levy and various other factors in order to make up for their own incompetence. It's also important to note that South Africa is currently in a recession. The last two quarters had a contraction of the GDP, which means that we are currently in our third recession since the dawn of democracy. The first one came in 2008, which affected everybody around the world. But over the last 2 years, under the leadership of our president, Cyril Ramaphosa, we have gone into a technical recession. Now, to put this even further into perspective, during the 2008 global recession, the GDP of South Africa contracted by 1.5%. In the last quarter of 2019 in South Africa, our GDP contracted by 1.4%. Now, in 2008, South Africa lost 1 million jobs with a contraction of 1.5%. Now, with a contraction of 1.4% in the last quarter of 2019, how many job losses are we going to face in South Africa? Now, speaking about job losses, currently the unemployment rate in South Africa is 29.1%. Now, that is close to a third of the population being unemployed. And if you have to break that down even further, 54% of the youth are currently unemployed. Now, asking the obvious questions, why is the economy in South Africa doing so bad when other Southern African countries are thriving and when Africa in general is thriving when it comes to building their economies? Well, the answer is simple. We've got rolling blackouts in this country that affects people between 4 to 12 hours when it takes place, which means businesses can't trade, they can't do their thing, because we need electricity. And unfortunately, South Africa can't provide that demand, not even to businesses, but also not to households. Then added to that, we've got two very anti-investment policies that are currently wanting to be passed by the government. And this is expropriation without compensation, which means that businesses, if they decide to come and spend billions or trillions of rand in investment in South Africa, they can't be assured that the land that they build their factories on will be theirs. Now, who will invest if they can't know whether the land will remain theirs and the upgrades made to that land? Now, the second policy is the National Health Insurance Bill that people are trying to pass, which means that you won't really have that big of a say of who you can go and see with regards to illnesses that you might have. The government want to take control of all of this and they want to nationalize it so that they are in charge of who you can go and see. And that is also not a good environment for people that would like to invest in a country to see if they can get the best healthcare possible. And it's simply not going to work. So with the amount of debt we have and the failure to service that debt, as well as the unemployment rate we have in this country, and also the proposed policies that make South Africa uninvestable, means that this recession that we are currently in is only going to get worse. Especially if you consider the fact that one of our biggest trading partners, China, is currently faced with an epidemic of insane proportions. Now, corruption is a big issue in this country because so many people are still living below the breadline. So we have many people that are living in poverty, and the money that was stolen by the government could have been utilized to improve service delivery as well as basic services to these individuals. Now, how much since 1994 has been lost to corruption? Well, the conservative estimate is 1.5 trillion rand. Now, it's important to note that our current president, Cyril Ramaphosa, came out and said that under the last decade of Jacob Zuma, our former president, they estimate that the corruption amount was 1 trillion rand. So that is just in 9 years under Jacob Zuma, where the corruption was close to 1 trillion rand. And corruption, unfortunately, is something that was prevalent since the dawn of democracy in this country, and clearly before, but we are counting it as a democracy when everybody was equal via our constitution. So 1.5 trillion rand since we became a democracy in South Africa. And that's a conservative number. Now, what makes all of this really disappointing is that the government hasn't acted against these individuals that has stolen over 1.5 trillion rand. You would expect a massive surge of arrests taking place, politicians and business owners that formed part of this corruption to have been arrested and put in jail. Well, unfortunately, that is not true. In actual fact, if there was a handful of arrests of individuals, then that would be a lot. There are currently many talk shops like the Zondo Commission in which people come out and say, yes, that this company was corrupt or this government official was corrupt, but there hasn't been any arrests. And that is a really problematic thing. I believe that it's now been 1.5 years of the Zondo Commission existing, which was to look into state capture in South Africa under former President Jacob Zuma. But there has not been one arrest of a politician under that state capture commission. And that is pretty much the problem with regards to South Africa, is that corruption is rampant, people are caught red-handed, but yet no action is taken by the government. If anything, they get redeployed within the government. And this has been a hallmark of the ANC government. You will find somebody breaching terms and conditions, their contract, or they were found with their hand in the cookie jar, and instead of being dismissed, they get redeployed into another department within the same ANC government. And that is pretty much the culture that we have in this country, where people aren't being held accountable and they aren't arrested. So to end off this video, I wanted to cover those three main topics, and I know that I've missed a bunch of things like broad-based black economic empowerment, employment equity, and various other topics, but I wanted to break this down into a pocket size index for people that would like to share this video with their friends, family, and people overseas to see what is currently going on in South Africa in the year of our Lord 2020. So please do me a favor and share this video far and wide with people that you might know so that they can actually see what the current state of South Africa is. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by clicking the join button below. Also, please be sure to subscribe. And if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so you can be notified of my future uploads. Also, please be sure to drop a comment. Let me know what you think, as well as smashing that like button. Let's see if we can get 1,222 likes on this video, and that would represent that we are now fully aware of what is actually going on in South Africa. Lastly, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.